Hello friends, welcome. Just going to do a workshop for working with spirit healing guides and passing that healing ray on to the patient. Now, the patient can be human, animal, even a plant if you wanted. So, I mean, all life has spirit. Now, the healing energies come from God, the source, or if you prefer to believe the universe, that's up to you. And, it works. And you tune into it and attune to those healing vibrations, to God. You say your prayer if you want to, or tune into the universal powers that God puts there, whatever you want to believe, that you start to channel it. And, you know, that those of you that have spirit guides and realize they're there, that you can work with them too. Now, what happens when you work with spirit guides, even if you're not aware you've got spirit guides, most often they are channeling it. So it comes from God to your spirit guide, through your spirit to the patient's spirit. So what you heal is the spirit of the patient, because then it passes on to the physical life. So you heal a patient that's got a lot of physical illness, and there's not much effect the first time you heal them, maybe not the second or third time if you're healing them once or twice a week, because the spirit has become so depleted with all these physical ailments that are reflected in the spirit as disharmonies that it needs to be charged up again. And, you know, those, until those disharmonies of the spirit are somewhat charged up, it doesn't pass on to the physical body so much. A little bit, yes, but that's what it does. It heals the spirit and thereby passes on to the physical body from the spirit and helps to heal, the physical body or mind, you know, and mental, emotional problems. Anything can be healed and alleviated. And, you know, people that have got mental illnesses, it takes great darkness out of their mind and suffering and such like. It can alleviate pain, symptoms. It's complementary. It's as well as normal medicine or alternative medicine. It helps recovery. So it's not a miracle cure in most cases, of course not. The odd person, it works very well. And another person with the same condition doesn't work so well. So it's just one of those things. You know, we don't exactly understand why one patient with an identical condition to another seems to greatly improve with healing and another doesn't. It could be something that they're blocking it slightly to some extent, maybe, but we don't know. So we do our best. Now, as a healer, all you want to be is an open tap, you know, because if you start manipulating those energies that God's sending, or if you believe the universe is transmitting through you, channeling through you, then you start to manipulate those energies and you start blocking some of the good ones quite often. So just be the open tap, like a tap, like the healing energy is water flowing through your mind, body, out through your hands to the patient. Or, you know, if you're doing absent healing, then you send it from your mind. You can hold your hands up still if you want to and send that energy out to that patient for whatever their needs might be, because they might have specific needs that you know about. And you give them healing for those needs, and you give them more healing for those needs. But they always need general healing, because you heal one thing and quite often there's something else causing it, or several other conditions suffered at the same time that also need healing. So it's holistic. So when you're healing, it's best to go around the whole body if you can and heal, starting with the shoulders quite often, to tune in to the vibration of spirit, the healing vibration, and channel it through yourself to the patient. So that's just about, you know, channeling it. Now, when you begin healing, if you've got a healing bed, for instance, you can run your hand over the patient and you can feel heat reflected from their mind or body, wherever they've got a very bad disharmony quite often. Not everybody can feel that. Now, that's just generally about healing, of course. Now, this video is more about working with spirit guides. So when you do healing, though, you know, move yourself around their body, start off on the shoulders, do the head, because if you can help them to relax mentally at the beginning of the healing after you've tuned in, then they're relaxed and more open to receive it. Whereas you start off, you know, healing their back or their chest or their, you know, legs first, then the mind is not relaxed and they're less able to absorb that healing. So I personally say tune in on the shoulders for a few minutes and give them some healing, and it builds up within them, and then do the mind, because it helps them to relax. So that's important, to get your patient as relaxed as possible. Always say, do you mind hands-on healing? At any time, if you feel uncomfortable or you want a itch, please do so. Please say if you're uncomfortable about me touching you anywhere, you know, whatever you've got to say to them. Now, again, as I say, that healing is coming from God or the universe that he puts out there for us to use. So he wants us to be able to heal. And we'll just about, whether we know it or not, have a healing guide passing those energies to us. A person that's a fairly progressed healer in the spirit realm that wants to work with mortals and pass that healing to them. Now, mostly with healers that are just, you know, unaware psychically and spiritually, all they're doing really is passing those healing rays to that healing healer so they can channel them like that open tap, like water flowing through you, the healing energies to the patient. They're just channeling it to you and you pass it on, and they don't manipulate it too much either. They give what's in the purest form, but spirit are much more aware of what's wrong with a person. They can see it psychically much more than we can, because our physical bodies slow these things down, make us less aware of these things, whereas a spirit healing guide can see a depletion in a person just by looking at them, you know, or in their mind. They can tell what sort of healing they might need for that sort of emotional trauma maybe, or different things. So they do change it, the healer, the spirit guide sometimes, because they know what is intuitively right for that person. Now, as a healer, you become intuitive too, and you give that healing, you can feel it flowing through you, and you can feel warmth in your hands. And when you've given enough healing to that area, you can feel the flow stop and your hands go cold, and you know it's time to move on to the next place. Now, that's what you can do. Now, you want to work with spirit, you've got to do it safely. So you want to tune into your spirit guide, your healing guide, and the first thing you have to say is, please work with me. Because if you don't invite them, they won't come to you. They don't come uninvited. So you've got to ask first. They give healing anytime you're working, giving healing. They pass it to you. But until they're invited, they won't work more directly and give you impressions or overshadow you, or at the most, take you into trance healing. Whereas they take complete control of you. Your mind's pushed to one side and they heal the patient through your body and through your spirit. So, yeah, that's at the greatest trance healing. But, you know, a lot of people want to stay in control of their own faculties and such like. And spirit guides can give great impressions where to go on a person, and you can psychically feel the colours they're giving or the certain energies they're giving. Sometimes a cold energy, sometimes warm, sometimes very hot, different energies for different things. So, excuse me. So, you know, you become aware. Now, it's important if you're going to become aware of spirit and any meditation, to ground yourself first, and that is to make a connection and let roots grow down through your feet to the earth and ground all your negative worries, daily cares, negative energies out of your spirit into the earth. Let it flow down those roots into the earth and let the beautiful terracotta energies of the earth come up into your body and spirit and harmonize you. And that's what it does. And it brings you into a more peaceful state, which obviously the more peaceful you are, the more spiritually receptive you are. So, yeah, so tune in, have some nice gentle music on, some Reiki music or something, just to get you in the mood. And, you know, when you're healing, always make sure you're clean and tidy and everything, so that you don't smell of cigarettes or whatever it is. And, you know, get the right atmosphere going. And then, you know, protect yourself, because any spirit meditation, you're working with your guide, but another spirit can come in and communicate with you that might be an imposter, and, you know, you don't want there. So protection is always important. To see a light come down through the top of your crown chakra, all through your chakras, filling your whole spirit up from your feet, up through your body with light. And it flows out the top of your head into your aura and expands beyond your aura and forms a big bubble, a shield of light around you to protect you from negative emanations. And that can be from another person down here that you pick up, or a negative spirit that's about. So it's always important to protect. After you've finished your meditation or your healing, then you don't need to get rid of that light and close it down. You just let it disperse in its own time, that protective barrier of light, because light repels darkness, you see. So always be in a positive state of mind. If you feel very down or very negative, it's best not to heal that day, you know, cancel your appointment, whatever it is, because when you're feeling really down, you can pass that on to the patient, plus you're very depleted and won't be able to channel that much energy as usual. So it's important to close down after you've finished. So after you finish, sorry. So let that energy disperse, that bubble of light. Now, when you've finished, you must close down, because otherwise you're walking around Tesco's or supermarket and you're picking up all these emotions from people around you going, oh, I feel so depressed, so miserable. I feel horrible today. And, you know, it's because you're picking it all up from other people, because you become more psychically aware. Because when you heal, your spirit brightens, your chakra expand, and you channel more healing by doing that. So you open all those chakras up in your body before you start healing. And it's, you know, once you get very practiced, it's just like turning a light switch on. But you can go through the process of seeing all your chakras: crown chakra, brow chakra, throat chakra, heart chakra, solar plexus, spleen chakra and base chakra all brightening and opening, your spirit brightening and opening, and that allows you to channel more and more of that energy, that healing energy, to the patient. And when you're finished, you must close down. So you see your spirit dimming down. You see all your chakras closing down to a normal state again, so that you're not walking around receptive and picking up feelings, or getting spirit coming and communicating to you nonstop, and your confusion and all sorts of things going wrong. So you can get in big problems with that. The other thing you must be aware of, that when you're healing, you can sometimes feel a condition of somebody, whether you're meditating one day and you've got a pain in your side or in your chest or something, you don't know what's causing it. It's quite often spirit giving that saying, we need you to send out a healing thought for that person or the patient you're healing that day. You can feel a pain in you or a numbness or something in you that's abnormal, or your neck's hurting. And you can say to that patient, is your neck hurting today? Yes, it is actually. So, you know, you can get effects of what a patient's suffering put onto you by spirit. And once you've said, sent out a thought for healing for that person, or sent healing to that person, you might not know who they are, or to the patient you're with at the time, you just then to say to spirit, thank you, take it away now, and it'll go. So now, you shouldn't use any of your own spirit energies when you give healing, because if you do, you become depleted yourself and you're not able to heal. Just channel the energy that's given to you through you. And even when you do that, you still use a tiny amount of your energies. Now, spirit, when they're working with you, will blend in your aura, and they will work with you, and they start to impress you, and you feel drawn to a certain area. Maybe you're healing somebody's back. You feel drawn to one side, to their shoulder or something, because there's a need of more healing there. And that's just intuitively, you feel drawn to that area of a person. That spirit will guide you around a person to where their most needs are. So just go with the flow, be intuitive, listen, open your mind, let yourself go to that place where you're needed. So you feel pulled to it, you feel drawn to it. Now, you want to become aware of spirit. Now, I'd advise joining a circle and developing your spirit latent abilities to communicate with spirit. And, you know, there are meditations that I do online to do that, but you can get a rapport and communication with spirit, but you don't always do that as a healer. So that's your choice whether to go down that road or not. But, you know, you can get impressions that this spirit's given you. They can learn to overshadow you. And, you know, it's like almost they're superimposing themselves onto you, and they're moving your hands around the patient and going to certain areas. It's almost like you're not doing it rather than being drawn. It's like they're moving their hands, and you go deeper and deeper into that. It can eventually become trance, where the spirit's almost completely in control of you, even though you're conscious still, or deep trance healing, where the spirit, you know, you give yourself over to that spirit and you let them relinquish your control of your conscious mind, and your conscious mind goes to one side, and that spirit comes in and takes control of you and heals through you. Now, don't do that unless you're very experienced in your spiritual latent abilities, that you've got a good rapport with spirit, you understand what's going on, you know that spirit in particular, you can trust them. You need to learn to trust spirit. Don't just give yourself over. A lot of new people, you know, they just go with the flow and let it happen, but it's not advisable to do that until you're experienced. So, you know, go through all that, and, you know, you give yourself over to spirit to use you as a channel if you want to work with them and let them work through you and overshadow you. But otherwise, you can just build up that rapport, and you can tell them too much, too quick. You know what I mean? If it's too much for you, just take it at your own pace, you know, and your own rate, little bit at a time, little step at a time, and they progressively go further with you and keep developing you in different ways. So that's what you do. Anyway, excuse me. So, you know, there's many different ways you can work with spirit guides. You've probably got one, more than one spirit guide. If you're a healer, then you attract maybe a couple of different spirit to you that are healers, and they work in different ways with you and different energies and stuff. But, you know, you can trust them that they know what's best for that patient. Now, when you've finished healing, and most healers are quite happy to do nothing more than just close down, which is you must close down, of course, as I've said, but most healers are they say thank you to their guides, you know, and that's polite. And they say thank you maybe to God or the universal forces, whatever they believe in. And that's polite, isn't it? And nice and courteous to do that. And, you know, but it's important when you finish healing, when you just finished that patient, to close that patient down, because you've opened all their chakras up and they're going to be walking around open to all these spiritual perceptions, maybe, in time, as you keep healing them. So close them down. Just run your hands over their spirit, dimming their spirit down to a normal state, dimming all their chakras down to a normal state so that they're closed, and then close yourself down. Now, at the end, there's two things you can ask for, because if you are using too much of your own energies, and you do always use a little bit of them, you suddenly find 2 hours later that patient had a bad neck, and suddenly your neck's going, oh, it's really stiff. You know, you've got a stiff neck, or you've got a condition that you've taken on to your own spirit because you use too much of your own energies, and you take their depletions onto yourself. Now, whether you do or you don't take their depletions onto yourself, it's not bad to say, please, Father God, take away anything I may have taken onto my own spirit from the patient during this healing. Thank you for hearing my prayer. You know, so that's just asking God, or you can ask the universe, or you can ask your spirit guides to do that. Say, please take anything I might have taken on during healing away from me. To your spirit guide, just send your thought out to them. Or you can also ask for recharge of spirit. Because if you're doing a lot of healing, you do use a bit of your own energy, and you might find yourself feeling a bit depleted sometimes. And just to say, please may I have recharge, Father God, of my spiritual being. And that just gets Father God to charge up your spirit back to a normal state again. Because the more depleted you become, it's like a battery getting discharged, the less healing you can pass to the patient. So important to keep, you know, keep your spirit topped up. So you can ask your spirit guide for that also. Or, you know, whatever you want to believe, the universe. Ask for recharge of your spirit to charge your battery up so you stay in tip-top condition. Now, you don't need to do that after every patient, just at the end of healing, you know. And, you know, you just open up once, you close down once at the end of healing. Even if you're doing it all day long, you only have to do it once. So you're in a prepared state. I mean, I always try to say a little prayer for each patient. You know, please, Father God, give this person whatever they need. So that's just polite, isn't it? Anyway, I hope that's informative to you. It's a little insight into that. And, you know, healers quite often progress to be good mediums and other spiritual workers too. So love and light to you. Bless you. Shep.